Beloved in the Lord, we are gathered here in the presence of God for the purpose of joining in marriage Stuart Bruce Choker and Spencer Marie McKinnon. Let us reverently call to mind the institution, purpose, and obligations of the marriage state. But first, who gives this woman to this man?
Her mother and I.
Brothers and sisters, the holy bond of marriage was instituted by God himself at the very dawn of history. Making man in his own likeness, he endowed him with many blessings and gave him dominion over all things. Moreover, God said, "It is not good for the man to be alone. I will make a helper suitable for him." So God created woman out of man's own substance and brought her to the man. For this reason, a man will leave his father and his mother and be united to his wife, and they will become one flesh. Our Lord Jesus honored marriage by his blessed presence at the wedding in Cana and confirmed it as a divine ordinance, as an honorable estate, and as a lasting bond when he declared, "Therefore, what God has joined together, let not man separate." Brothers and sisters, you don't need to stand for all of this. Why don't you go ahead and sit down? Sorry, I should have mentioned that earlier.
We have to stand for all of this, though.
The Apostle Paul shows its exalted nature when he calls marriage a symbol of the mystic union of the Savior and the Church, his redeemed bride, commending it as a state honorable among all. Marriage was established to extend the human race, to advance the kingdom of God, and to enrich the lives of those entering this state. To fulfill these purposes, a husband and wife must be lovingly devoted to each other, sharing responsibility for the nurture of the children the Lord may give them as his heritage and as parties to his covenant. The Lord ordained that in marriage, the husband should be the head of the wife, even as Christ is the head of the church, and that he should protect her and provide for her in love. This love, if exercised in the spirit and example of Christ, will be conducive to mutual happiness. God also ordained that the wife should be subject to the husband in all things that are according to his word, showing him obedience, even as the church shows obedience to Christ. Thus, the liberty of both the husband and the wife is glorified by the mutual loyalty to God. And the home begun in the name of the Lord and regulated by his commandments becomes the very foundation of a Christian society and provides a foretaste to the eternal home. Marriage, then, is a divine ordinance intended to be a source of happiness to us, an institution of the highest significance to the human race, and a symbol of the union of Christ and his church. We may, therefore, as Christians, look with confidence for grace from God in fulfilling our mutual responsibilities to God and for guidance and help from God in solving our common problems. Stuart and Spencer, now that you have heard God's message concerning marriage, do you agree with it? And do you desire to enter into this holy estate as ordained by God? Stuart, what is your answer?
I do.
And Spencer, what is your answer?
I do.
Brothers and sisters, let us pray. O God of wonder and of joy, grace comes from you, and you alone are the source of life and love. Without you, we cannot please you. Without your love, our deeds are worth nothing. send your Holy Spirit and pour into our hearts that most excellent gift of love, that we may worship you now with thankful hearts and serve you always with inspired minds. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Brothers and sisters, listen now to the will of God who created marriage, as he has communicated it through the Apostle Paul in Paul's letter to the Ephesians, chapter 5, verses 22 through 33. Wives, submit yourselves unto your own husbands, as unto the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, even as Christ is the head of the church, and he is the Savior of the body. Therefore, as the church is subject unto Christ, so let wives be to their own husbands in everything. Husbands, love your wives, even as Christ also loved the church, and gave himself for it, that he might sanctify and cleanse it with the washing of water by the word, that he might present it to himself a glorious church, not having spot or wrinkle or any such thing, but that it should be holy and without blemish. So ought men to love their wives as their own bodies. He that loveth his wife loveth himself. For no man ever yet hated his own flesh, but nourisheth and cherisheth it, even as the Lord the church. For we are members of his body, of his flesh, and of his bones. For this cause shall a man leave his father and mother, and be joined unto his wife, and they two shall be one flesh. This is a great mystery, but I speak concerning Christ and the church. Nevertheless, let every one of you in particular so love his wife, even as himself, and the wife see that she reverence her husband. Brothers and sisters, Jesus said that he has come that we might have life and that we might have it more abundantly. But what is life? What is this life of which Jesus speaks? Does Jesus only speak of life after our death, life in heaven, or life after he returns? Or does he also speak of abundant life in this life? And if so, what is that life? What is life? Is it prosperity, fame, popularity? Many celebrities have these things in abundance, but they do not find life. Many of them end their lives through drug addiction, drug overdoses, and suicide. These things, fame, fortune, health, these are not life. What then is life? Life is communion with our Creator. It is gratitude to our Redeemer. It is worship to the God who created all things, who created us, and who redeemed us through the shed blood of His Son. And that life, if he gives that life into our souls, he gives us the ability to love one another. He gives wives the ability to respect and obey their husbands. He gives husbands the ability to love their wives self-sacrificially. This is life, communion with God. And these things do not come from our willpower. These things are gifts from the hand of Almighty God. They are acts of grace. They are miracles that He works in our hearts through the power of His Holy Spirit. Let us pray. Dear Lord and Father, you are a Father who knows how to give good gifts to your children. Lord, give us the gift of communion with you, of love for you, of loyalty to you, obedience to you. And through that, give us the gift of love for one another. Bless Stuart and Spencer with this love for you and with this love for each other. Cause that their marriage may bring glory to your name. For you, Lord, alone are worthy of all glory, of all loyalty, of all worship. We pray this in the name of your beloved Son, Jesus Christ. Amen. Stuart and Spencer have written their own vows, and now is a time for them to share their vows with each other. Stuart, your vows are on 2 pages. I apologize for that. So you will need to turn the page at that point. You're right there.
Hi, Stuart Bruce Choker. Take you, Spencer Marie McKinnon, to be my wife. To love you, hold you, and cherish you. To encourage, honor, and uplift you. To lead you, protect you, and provide for you. To bring you every blessing and the joy that is in my power. I will never leave you as long as this life shall last. And when, finally, death parts us, I shall meet you again before the face of God.
I, Spencer Marie McKinnon, take you, Stuart Bruce Choker, to be my husband, to love you, hold you, and cherish you, to encourage, honor, and uplift you, to follow you, counsel you, and strengthen you, to bring you every blessing and joy that is in my power. I will never leave you as long as this life shall last. And when, finally, death part us, I shall meet you again before the face of God.
And now, Stuart and Spencer have a gift of rings to give to each other. Stuart, you will speak first.
Father.
With this ring, I bind myself to you, pledge you my faithfulness and my undying love.
Stuart, with this ring, I bind myself to you and pledge you my faithfulness and undying love. You get it on your knuckle.
Brothers and sisters, in the presence of God and before this congregation, Stuart and Spencer have given their consent and made their marriage vows to each other. They have declared their marriage by the joining of hands and by the giving and receiving of rings. I therefore proclaim that they are husband and wife. You may now kiss your bride. Those whom God has joined together, let no one put asunder. Let us pray. Blessed are you, O Lord our God, for you have created joy and gladness, pleasure and delight, love, peace, and fellowship. Pour out the abundance of your blessings upon Stuart and Spencer in their new life together. Let their love for each other be a seal upon their hearts and a crown upon their heads. Bless them in their work and in their companionship, awake and asleep, in joy and in sorrow, in life and in death. Finally, in your mercy, bring them to that banquet where your saints feast forever in your heavenly home. We ask this through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Stuart and Spencer, God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, bless, preserve, and keep you. The Lord mercifully grant you the riches of his grace, that you may please him both in body and in soul, and in living together in faith and love, may receive the blessings of eternal life. Amen. Brothers and sisters, let us pray with confidence, as our Savior has taught us. Let us pray out loud together the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Brothers and sisters, Stuart and Spencer, God, the Holy Trinity, make you strong in faith and love, defend you on every side, and guide you in truth and peace. And the blessings of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be among you and remain with you always. Amen. And finally, brothers and sisters, I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Stuart Choker. Now, we invite you all to proceed row by row, starting from the front, to congratulate Stuart and Spencer in the receiving line.